Welcome everybody. Welcome to Aastha Consulting. Today we are here to provide you complete information about Saudi employment visa details. So before starting, we would like to request you to please like, subscribe, comment and share. So let's start. I just wanted to give you just a snapshot of what all categories of visa available in Saudi Arabia. So first category is visit visa. Second category is resident visa. Third category is employment visa. Fourth category is tourist visa. And fifth category is Hajj and Umrah visa. So we'll be going to create separate videos for all the categories so that you have detailed information. If we try to combine everything, then this video will be very long. So that's the reason we'll be covering all the different kind of visa stamping in Saudi Arabia in a separate video. So today what we are covering is employment visa for Saudi Arabia. So we're going to cover the entire end-to-end process for that. So let's begin. We talk about employment visa process start immediately the person get selected with any of the organization in Saudi Arabia. So the moment the person got selected either into professional category or domestic categories, he or she will get an offer letter, and the moment he signed off the offer letter, the company will assign visa to their partner agency in India. So the moment visa assigned, like if we give an example of Aastha Consulting, and if any of our candidates from Aastha Consulting got selected, so we immediately request visa to the concerned company. And the moment they share the visa, sometimes we already have visa with us, so based on the post selection we immediately process. Sometimes we don't have the visa, we request the company to please provide us the visa. So the moment we get the wakala, wakala is basically the moment they assign a visa to the concerned agency like us. So we get in the form of wakala. Wakala is nothing, it's just a set of information that they assign visa on our shared license detail. So the moment we get the visa, we will provide visa number, visa date to the candidate, and we provide them that, we suggest them to log into Gamka website, and because now we don't have any Gamka office. Earlier it was Gamka office where you have to go with the passport and visa details, and they make one receipt by paying some amount, approximately 700-800, and whatever the medical center mentioned, you have to go through. Now the same process is online. So what you have to do, you have to go to Gamka website. We will provide you the link for the Gamka website in the description. So you need to log in, you have to go and mention your name, your passport number, passport detail, visa as you provided, visa number and visa date, and you have to choose the city where you want to go for the medical and the date. So all the basic information, necessary information you have to provide, and then we have to make a payment of $10. Then there is a receipt will generate, and randomly they pick a medical center in that particular city, and whatever the medical center name mentioned in the Gamka slip, you have to go to that medical center only for the medical. So what exactly document required to go for the Gamka medical? That for that purpose we need a passport, new passport, and you must have to check before processing for Saudi visa, your passport must have validity of more than 6 months, then only you can travel to Saudi Arabia. If it's 6 to 7 months, then there's a problem, you go for the renewal, otherwise you might face problem in terms of traveling, because if visa process take sometime longer time and you fall in less than 6 months validity, then you cannot travel. So the entire effort will be wasted. So you have to check before going for the medical that your passport validity is more than 6 months. I can say, although it's 6 months, but I will suggest it's more than 8 months, so that you can go and at least get the renewal in Saudi Arabia. So you need, for going for the Gamka medical, you need passport, you need a white color photo, white background color photograph. I will you need four, five passport for the medical, and six, seven passport for the visa stamping, and you have to carry around 8 to 10 photograph before, along with traveling to Saudi Arabia. So, and never change photograph in medical and visa stamping. Don't use two different photos in two different process, visa stamping and medical. Otherwise, sometime what happened, you used 2-3 years back photograph in medical and latest photo in visa stamping. If there's any face change and there's an issue, they will not stamp your visa. So I will suggest go for the go for the snap and get the latest photograph, and at least get it 30 copy of the same, and use the same photograph for medical, visa stamping, and carry the same photo in Saudi Arabia for preparing your Iqama and other medical formalities and other stuff. So I'm repeating again, summarizing, for going for the medical, you need passport, you need photograph, you need a gamka slip, and you need gamka slip and visa information that we have provided, visa number and visa date. So these are the documents required to go for the medical, and there's a fees approximately 5,500, or at least you carry 6,000 along with you. Then go with empty stomach so that there'll be no problem. In general, we go for the medical empty stomach only, and if you can take one or two coconut water, will definitely add value. So it will, if there's any scar because of the smoking or anything, this will help us to reduce a bit. Definitely this is not a medicine to cure complete problem, but definitely it will benefit a little bit. So then you go to medical center and provide your necessary documentation and the fee. Then they will register you. They will register you, and then you go for the complete medical. And they will definitely ask for the MOFA number. MOFA number, you can tell them that immediately, the moment we get information that I am medically fit, then I'll provide you the MOFA number. Because for generating MOFA number, that agency has to pay around some amount. I don't want to disclose the amount actually. So some amount, they need to upload your passport and photograph, passport copy and photograph to generate that. So if somebody get medical failure or disqualify in the medical because of any reason, that medical fee is not refundable, which will be wasted. And then definitely if there's any loss to the agency, which they will charge back to the candidate. So be on the safer side, better. I will suggest you to go for the medical, and immediately, the moment you get to know that you are medically fit, then share your passport copy and photograph copy with the agency. They will provide you the MOFA number, and the moment you share the MOFA number with the agency, they will update in their system, GAMKA system, and they will provide you the medical medical certificate. So now the moment they enter a MOFA number, your actual report will be online with the embassy so that they can cross check while doing the visa stamping. So the moment you get the medical report, then what you need to do, you need to share the same, your passport copy, medical report, gamka slip and photograph with your concerned agency, recruitment agency, for the visa, Saudi visa stamping, employment visa stamping. And they will then they will prepare the documentation, and they are going to submit to the embassy in Mumbai or Delhi. Then they will submit and get the, if it's successful, then they will get it in 2 days. Whatever, it's accepted or rejected. If it's rejected, then we have to make the correction what has been suggested by Saudi embassy, and we can resubmit and get the things done. In visa stamping also, there'll be two categories. If your visa is on the lower craft, you don't need any set of degree attestation, like for the labor, plumber, or those visa categories. So if your visa is technical category or any category where the relevant degree and diploma required matching to the visa category, so then what you need to do, you need to go for the degree or diploma attestation. So the moment you will get degree and the moment you have degree and diploma attested, that copy or attested original copy is also need to be submitted to the embassy along with the rest of the document. So the only difference In lower category or any category where degree diploma is not required, and another country category is where degree or diploma required, is just the document or just the degree or diploma. So I don't want to give you the detail about the degree attestation in this video, that we already have a separate video for the same. So for submitting the visa stamping, if it's a visa category where the degree and diploma is required, you have to submit degree and diploma along with the documentation what I have suggested: the passport, photograph, medical report, kamkar slip. That's it. And if it's a technical category, we need to provide relevant certificate attested by SOGI Embassy and Culture. So the moment we get the stamping done, we just need, so the entire process for Saudi employment is completed. You just need ticket to travel. Now post COVID scenario has changed, so now I will suggest everybody to go for the vaccination. And now as we know in India, two vaccination duration is 3 months, but if you got selected, now government has eased the process for the person who is seeking his career opportunity and got selected for the Middle East or any international location. If you have an offer letter, you can show to the authority and you can get vaccination done in within 28 days. So if you need any documentation proof, you can reach out us by commenting in our video. We will provide you the relevant link to you. So this is the all process all about employment visa stamping for Saudi Arabia. I am summarizing. The moment you got selected, you need to go on Gamkaf site to generate the Gamkaf slip. And the moment you generate Gamkaf slip, you need to go to the same medical which is mentioned in your Gamkaf slip and go with the documentation, passport, visa details, photograph and Gamkaf slip. And once your medical is once you get to know verbally your medical pass, then share the MOFA number with them, and the moment you share, then you will get the medical report done. Then you need to share all the documentation, medical report, passport also you need to share, old and new both if you have more than one passport, and then photograph. And if your visa category required any set of degree or diploma attested from Saudi Embassy, then you have to share original copy of that as well. And this is all about. So once your stamping is done, you try to get vaccination complete and then you travel. It's because now for those who are not vaccinated, they have to stay in quarantine in Saudi Arabia for 7 days. So as we know, like it's all about the cost. So quarantine in Saudi Arabia is costing us around 60 to 80,000 Indian rupees. So if we take 2 days, so this will saving our 70 to 80,000 Indian rupees. Plus, it is also giving us the opportunity to get another 7 days salary. So you have to calculate your two dose of vaccine is giving you saving your 80,000 rupees, but also simultaneously providing 7 days salary. So it's a double benefit combo. Double combo. So I will suggest go for all vaccination. This will save for you and your family and for all the society. So this is all about. I'm closing this video, and before going, I will suggest you to please like, subscribe, comment and share, so that we can take this Aastha platform to benefit more and more people. And we want to provide you complete information about all the queries that you are coming with us, and also suggest us on next video what all topic you want us to cover, so that we can prepare video accordingly. So that's all. So have a nice day and Jai Hind.